Listen to Alfred.
The music of arguably the coolest jazz group in history, the Dave Brubeck Quartet, will be faithfully reproduced at Ashmore Village Hall on the 30th of January. Arts Reach, the Dorset charity bringing live theatre, dance and music to the county's rural communities, is celebrating its 30th birthday this year, and they present the Neil Mayer Quartet. Totnes-based Neil has been touring with his collective since 2001.
I love his music, as I'm a sax player. I love the playing of Paul Desmond, Dave Brubeck's long-serving sax player, even more than I love the compositions of the Dave Brubeck Quartet.
Their Brubeck project has been around for 5 years, and Neil says the band members are huge fans of the cool jazz pianist and composer.
They were a super group in the late 50s and early 60s. You know, they were very, very well known and, really came out of jazz. They became, they entered the realm of pop music, which is not very common in jazz. People of a certain age just know what Brubeck does, and therefore it does what it says on the tin. But we describe it, it's sort of late 1950s, early 60s cool jazz. 90% of what we do on the gig is straight Brubeck. We do usually bring a couple of my own compositions along to the gig as well. It is different, it's all very accessible, and they sort of come along for the Brubeck and they go, oh, and we enjoyed that as well, so that's really nice.
The Dave Brubeck Quartet made jazz music fashionable and popular again for the post-war generation.
Two or three people come up to me at the end of a gig and tell me some wonderful story about when they saw Dave Brubeck, or how their first boyfriend or girlfriend was, you know, got them into Brubeck or something like that. So there's a lot of reminiscing going on.
Have you had people who saw Brubeck come up to you afterwards?
Loads of people. People have seen him even in his last tour, which I think was around the year 2000. I've had people come up to me and said, oh, we saw him when he was, you know, basically a very old man, and he was still touring at that point. By definition, some fairly elderly people say, I saw him in 1950 something or other, or it's been over loads and loads and loads over the years, and they give us good feedback, you know, that we're doing a good thing.
Now, when people perform Shakespeare, they have to be word perfect. They can't change the work of the bard because he's respected. So in the same way, do you put your own interpretation on any of Brubeck's pieces, or are they performed exactly as he would have?
There's sort of two aspects of what we call the head. So there's the tune, and then there's the improvisation aspects. Three quarters of what the Dave Brubeck Quartet did was improvisation. We don't learn and copy their improvisations. We improvise ourselves. That's why I do this thing. The style of improvisation is in a similar sort of vein to the style of improvisation that particularly Dave Brubeck and Paul Desmond did.
Part of the set, the group will play the quartet's most famous track, Take Five.
Which is interestingly not written by Dave Brubeck. That was actually written by Paul Desmond. And the other two very famous tunes are Blue Rondo à la Turque. And then his other very famous tune is Unsquare Dance. We'll be playing all of those. Plus slightly lesser known tunes like The Duke, which is in honour of Duke Ellington. In Your Own Sweet Way, which is written by Dave Brubeck for his wife, Iona. Dave Brubeck Quartet did a great album called Dave Digs Disney, and we're doing two tunes from that album, which is Hi Ho and Someday My Prince Will Come from Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. And we're taking Dave Brubeck's Strange Time signatures to the extreme with a tune called 11-4, which is 11 beats in the bar.
Neil says his audiences generally sit to appreciate the music.
People don't get up and dance to it. We're playing concert jazz, so usually it's not set up like that.
Neil performs with an accomplished group.
I'm just so fortunate to be working with some of the Southwest's finest musicians.
Neil's been playing jazz professionally for a quarter of a century and says that's fairly unusual, because it's not the most lucrative genre.
It's really hard to make your way through jazz. It's not the best financial rewards, I suppose. It's and there's an awful lot of fantastic jazz musicians out there, but somehow I've been very lucky, I think.
The band's performing at Ashmore Village Hall for the first time. It's not a massive venue, but he says he enjoys intimate rural gigs.
These halls can hold usually 50, 100 people, something like that. That's brilliant. It makes for a lovely, intimate gig. We get a chance to meet people a bit more personally than, you know, a bigger venue. And sometimes the acoustics are really great in these village halls. They're rarely terrible.
The show starts at 7:30 p.m. on Thursday, the 30th of January. You can get more information on the ArtsReach website at artsreach.co.uk.
Listen to Alfred.